mentioned the battle of Armageddon. Let's make a correction. This naming is not an Islamic naming. This is a biblical naming. So this is a Christian and Jewish narrative. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم called it مقتلة عظيمة. مقتلة عظيمة or fierce killing, a lot of killing. Now, there is a reference to this battle في صحيح الإمام مسلم. حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وسلم تصالحون الروم صلحا آمنا, that you're going to have some sort of peace accord with the Western world. Now Allah is addressing the Muslim world. Now, obviously, the public has nothing to do with this accord. So obviously, from the wording of that hadith, that this accord was established by the rulers, who we don't even, يعني, beside the point, يعني. So they did it on their own. And you will fight a common enemy from behind you. That's what the hadith says. And one of the principles of dealing with these ahadith, علامات الساعة, the signs of the day of judgment, that we don't try to close them. We don't try to give it a scenario. We don't say, okay, this is what is going to, because we don't know. That scenario happened so many times. We had common enemies before. Because a lot of people try to apply this to their time and all of that. We don't do that. We just narrate the hadith the way it is. If it is our time, it could be our time. If it is the next generation, it could be the next generation. And you will conquer. So now, the people of the Sunnah and the Romans, the Western world, the Christian world, the Judeo-Christian, let's put it this way, they will fight a common enemy and they will conquer. Then in their way back, a Christian will raise the cross and he will say, "Intasara al-Salib." We conquered because of the cross, because of Christianity, not because of your Islam. A Muslim, jealous one, will stand up and will refute that. And somehow the hadith indicates that he will kill that individual. And that what will trigger Armageddon, the so-called, yeah. وهذه المقتلة العظيمة. Now, Hadith Abdullah ibn Mas'ud mentions where? That's a place in Syria. It's called Marj Dabiq. And that's where the name Armageddon comes, you know, from there, from that place. So it's in Syria, not in Palestine, which is part of Sham. Hadith Abdullah ibn Mas'ud also in Sahih Imam Muslim. Yusayr ibn Jabir mentioned that a man came with a loud voice. There was a sandstorm that made the horizon so dusty and yellowish. So he's coming, rushing towards Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, who was reclining, who was laying down. And he is repeating, Yabna Mas'ud, qamat al-sa'a. Yabna Mas'ud, qamat al-sa'a. Yabna Mas'ud, qamat al-sa'a. Yabna Mas'ud, the hour is here. He considered this sandstorm and all these changes in the horizon are, you know, the events that would lead to the destruction of this world and the beginning of the Day of Judgment. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, just to show you the preciousness of knowledge, he was reclining, relaxing, and he sat and he looked at him and he said, not yet. Innaha lan taqoom. It's not time yet. And then where Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he was in al-Kufa, in Iraq. So he pointed towards the west. He pointed like this. عَدُوٌ لِأَهْلِ الْإِسْلَامِ, an enemy of the Muslims, will gather in this place. And he actually mentioned under 80 flags, 80 flags. And each flag will provide 20,000 soldiers. Look at the details now of this battle. So what is the numbers? 80 times 20,000, what? You're not good in math in Canada? No, you need a calculator? No way. How much? How many? They should be 906, 900, 960, I think, a million baht for. Huh? Yeah. Yeah, maybe I'm, is it the right thing? Sheikh Kamil, yeah? In any rate, that's huge. Yeah, it's a huge, huge army. They will come fighting the Muslims. And subhanallah, obviously, the leader of the Muslim at this time will be Imam Muhammad ibn Abdullah al-Mahdi. And Muslims actually will defeat the Romans in this battle, to your surprise, regardless of their numbers. And this actually will be the trigger of the major signs of the Day of Judgment. You see, this particular event is the transition between the minor signs and the major sign. Because in the wording of Imam Muslim, Hadith Abi Huraira, that after the battle ends, Shaitan will actually make an announcement. He will be so furious, so upset, so angry, that he's going to make an announcement in the battlefield. Don't rejoice. فَإِنَّ الدَّجَّالَ قَدْ خَلَفَكُمْ فِي ذَرَارِيكُمْ. The Dajjal is out. He's messing around with your family's back. And actually, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, imagine this. Then the Imam of the Muslims, although the hadith doesn't indicate Imam al-Mahdi, so just to be fair, yeah, doesn't say Imam al-Mahdi, but the Imam, the leader of the Muslims, whoever it is going to send 10 horsemen. Look at this now. Look at this. The Prophet says, Wallahi, by Allah, إِنِّي لَأَعْلَمُ أَسْمَاءَهُمْ وَأَسْمَاءَ آبَائِهِمْ. I know their first and family names. فَإِنَّهُمْ خَيْرُ فَوَارِسِ الْأَرْضِ يَوْمَئِذٍ. They are the best horsemen on the face of this earth at this time, who will go and verify whether that announcement was credible, authentic, or was it a lie. The hadith indicates that they will find out it was a lie, but Sheikh Al-Albani authenticated a hadith which says after the battle, the Prophet mentioned 16 months, Ad-Dajjal would come out. And I have a book, Ya Ikhwa, called The Afterlife Unveiled. We had a whole conference in Toronto about this, actually, about the afterlife. You call this. We actually spoke about this in details. If you go to Authentic Al Mission, we have all these lectures, inshallah. And I think Sheikh Kamil also presented that subject to the crowd. So this is a very fascinating subject. But this is our version. Yeah, our version. We have our own version, but we don't say Armageddon. I think there is another name called the Al-Malhama. Al-Malhama. Also, we can call it Al-Malhama. Barakallahu fi.
So the second part of your question about who's going to follow Mahdi alayhi salam. So, I mean, regarding the hadith of the black flags, there is a long discussion and entire booklets have been written on the authenticity and weakness and so on. But let me just give you a short answer for the sake of time. The followers of Mahdi alayhi salam would not only be from one area. Even if we were to accept the hadith of the black, that is one battalion who will come from Khorasan. Khorasan, exactly, I did some research on this, because nowadays there is a place in Iran that's called Khorasan. But we don't go by names today, like Najd today is in Saudiya, but in Nabu we talked about the Najd at that time being called in a part of Iraq. So there is a book called Fath al-Buldan. It talks about the victories in different lands, and it talks about where the lands are. So basically, in current day, northern Pakistan, most of Afghanistan, parts of Iran, and parts all the way into Uzbekistan, all this area used to be called Khorasan in the old times, right? So from there will be, according to the hadith, whether you accept the authenticity or not, that there will be people who will come to give Nusra to Mahdi alayhi salam with black flags. But just to be clear, that doesn't mean that's the only followers. There will be followers from all different parts of the Ummah. May Allah make us from them.